Welcome back to Film Time. Today's topic of conversation on the video is massive Pawn Star deals. So make sure to like the video up, subscribe to the channel, and let's get this thing going. Now, the Harrisons kind of lose their minds when it comes to cars. In one of the episodes of the show, Corey showed off his reckless spending habits by purchasing a mint condition 1969 Chevy Camaro Z28. Now, back in the day, this car was the most desirable Z28 of all, thanks to his one-of-a-kind combination of engine, exhaust, brakes, and induction options, despite the fact that it wasn't the fastest muscle car on the market. While the car itself is a collector's item that the older generation used to ride down memory lane, it wasn't a practical buy, nor did it have a business plan in mind. Corey bought it because he wanted to personally own the car himself, but that set himself up to make the pawn shop lose money. This purchase raised the alarm and concern, and upon finding out about it, Rick and the old man forced Corey to meet with the financial planner to limit his spending limit. Corey was eventually asked to hand out his credit card, which was then surprisingly slashed in half. And as if it wasn't bad enough, he was also forced to sell the car, but he reluctantly sold it. Eventually, the car was put on sale at different places for different prices, ranging from $50,000 to $100,000. Now, the car was never sold because the car was valued at $36,000, which makes this particular purchase one of the worst in history for Corey. In one story, after the passing of this man's grandmother, he cleaned out her belongings and came to the gold and silver pawn shop with a solid gold bar that he found hidden away in the box. Without actually knowing how much the gold bar was worth, he decided to take it to the gold and silver pawn shop to find out more about it. Now, simply just melting the gold bar would have brought the man $24,000. However, after an expert confirmed that the gold bar was from a 1554 Spanish shipwreck in Texas, the value was immediately doubled from $24,000 to $48,000. The lucky man agreed to sell the solid gold bar to Rick Harrison for $35,000, and it left both men happy with the transaction. Now, after word got out that an original version of the same artwork that Paul owned had sold for $6 million, Paul decided to take all four original paintings to the gold and silver pawn shop to see what type of deal he could get for the expensive artwork. His initial offer was $8,000 per piece of artwork for a total of $32,000. But Rick noticed the water damage and informed the customer Paul that right off the bat, the water damage was going to affect the total value of the artwork. He called in an expert to check the paintings out. The expert confirmed the authenticity of the painting. He stated that the paintings was early works from the 1950s. He also stated that since the water damage was only on the edges and it didn't affect the composition itself, the damage wasn't a big problem when it comes to looking at the artwork and selling it at the auction. It was also included that the paintings could go for around $10,000 a piece at auction, with two of them possibly selling for as much as $15,000. Now, after gathering all of that information, Rick remembered his commission fee that he would have to pay at auction, so he offered $24,000 for all four paintings, but Paul said that two of them would go for $30,000 by themselves. So they ended up settling for a deal for $27,000, and Paul left happy because he honestly didn't expect to get that much for the artwork at all. Now, if you're a professional at bargaining, then taking a trip across the country for a specified coin request by a customer isn't that big of a deal. In season 12, a regular customer told the owner, Rick Harrison, that they would be willing to pay a rough estimate of around $70,000 for an extremely rare 1950 Panama specific gold coin, which was enough for Rick Harrison to pack his things and go across the country to the biggest coin show in Florida in hopes of finding the coin. Now, aside from the rarity factor of the coin, these coins had an extreme historical value because it was created by the U.S. Mint to celebrate the opening of the Panama Canal. Rick Harrison managed to track down two of the coins at the auction and eventually managed to convince the seller to drop the price down to $67,500. And that'll wrap up today's video on massive Pawn Star deals. We hope you enjoyed the content. Make sure to leave a like on the video, subscribe to the channel if you are a new viewer, and we hope to have your continued support on our channel and in our future videos. We'll see you next time.